This is Mary Hodges from DP Services, and today we're looking at Claris Connect approvals using FileMaker. So I have a simple Claris Connect flow here that starts with a FileMaker script trigger, followed by an approval step. And then based on the results of that step, we're going to trigger a FileMaker script that updates the original record that triggered the flow in the first place. So let's take a look at how that all works. I've got my FileMaker file, and we need to do a few setup steps first. Obviously, you'll need a Claris Connect account. Additionally, you'll need to make sure that your file is hosted using a password-protected account, and make sure to enable the FM REST extended privilege. Let's just take a quick look at that. I'm using the admin account. We're going to go to Advanced Settings, and we can see that we've got the FM REST privilege enabled. From here, we're going to start our Claris Connect flow using the FileMaker server script trigger, and that's going to give us a callback URL. So let's take a look at that. Claris Connect gives you a bunch of instructions for how to set this up. I'm going to go ahead and copy the callback URL, pop that right in here, and then we can go to our sample form. So these are just our inputs for the approval step. And then this button will send the approval. Let's take a look at how that works. I'm using the Submit Purchase Order Request script. So a lot of this is error handling. I'm capturing the URL from the callback that we entered, and then just checking for some empty values. And I've got a user confirmation here. And then really, the magic happens here at step 62. This is where we're setting our parameter to feed to Claris Connect. So you can see I've got a few things here. Most of these are for the approval step itself. I'm also including the record ID from the FileMaker record. This is going to allow us to call back to that original record later in the flow. And I have this very important element here, which is the action script value pair. And that is included in the instructions from Claris Connect here at step 3. So from there, I'm going to close my dialog. From there, it's a simple insert from URL. So I've got a curl post request and insert from URL using that callback URL that we specified earlier. That's going to trigger our flow, and then we're going to have the approval step. So the approval inputs you can see are mostly from this step 1. And just to show you what that looks like, can go into the step, and we'll see all of our parameters from FileMaker that we passed as a JSON object. And then you can just click on one to enter it into your parameters here for the approval step. You could hard code some of these. You could have them be dynamic as they are here. I chose to make the due date static, so I'm just specifying one day. And let me go ahead and save this. Save that. And then based on the results of the approval itself, we're going to execute a FileMaker script. To execute a FileMaker script from the Claris Connect flow, we're going to need to specify which layout we're using, and of course, which script we're using here. The script parameter can only be a string. So you can see I've got a few different data points here, but I am concatenating them using a pipe delimiter. And then we're going to parse that in the FileMaker script. So let's go back to this script, which is called approval response. So here we're getting our script parameter from Claris Connect, and then we're parsing those pipe delimited values using the substitute function. And then we're using this record ID. I have a field here called record ID. Which is just an auto enter calc using get record ID. You could match on another field, you could match on a primary key. We're using this to find our record. And then once we've found it, we are updating the status, again, based on the input from Claris Connect and adding also the comment from the approver. So let's take a look at how this all works in reality. I'm gonna go ahead and enter my title. And the name that I'm sending it to. And I'll go ahead and enter my request here. And let's go ahead and submit our request. This is triggering the Claris Connect flow. And momentarily, I'll see that email come in. There it goes. And here's my email. And in this case, it's coming from the FileMaker user account that I set up. And you can see that here in our approval step. That's the approval name. So if this was a real user account name, then it would come from that person. You can, of course, change these parameters in your FileMaker scripting or here in your Claris Connect flow. Let's go back to this email and we'll go ahead and reply. And I'm going to approve this. That takes the user who's approving to a thank you page. And if I go back to my FileMaker file, you can see I've got the response here and my approval status has been updated. And here in Claris Connect, we can look at the history and see each step and what the inputs were. And then here is my approval result here. And additionally, we can look at the approval history, not for the flow, but for the actual approvals themselves. So let's go ahead and set this to approved and search. And there is my approval that I just entered. And that is how easy it is to set up Claris Connect approvals using FileMaker. For more assistance working with Claris Connect and FileMaker, please give us a call.